Hello everyone, here we give an introduction about probability. Probability is the measure of the chance that something will happen. We use probability to describe how much chance something may happen. There are three keywords to understand the probability: experiment, outcome, and event. An experiment is a process which has more than one possible result, but only one will occur, and it is uncertain which one will appear before the experiment. Outcome is a particular result of an experiment. So the experiment may have many possible outcomes. We do not know which one will happen before the experiment is done. Event is considered a collection of one or more outcomes of an experiment. Probability is a value between 0 and 1 inclusive. When we talk about the chance something going to happen, the lowest the situation would be 0. No chance. That means something is not going to happen. And the highest the chance, highest the situation, the maximum would be 100%. So that is 1. So the probability must be the number between 0% and 100%. That is 0 and 1. A trial is an act of testing something based on an experiment. We can use Venn diagrams to describe the relationship between events and to describe the probability in a geometrical way. For convenience to understand this concept, rectangular area represents all the possible outcomes, and each circle area represents the possible outcomes that event includes. And the proportion of the circle area takes in the whole rectangular area could be considered as the probability of corresponding event. Of course, we do have an assumption in this case. We suppose every possible outcome has the equal chance to appear. Here is the typical example: standard playing cards being used to explain the classical probability situation. In this standard playing cards, and we have four different kind of symbol. The top one called the club, and the next one, next row, spade, and the next one, heart, and the last row is called the diamond. And you can see they are color coded as well. The top two rows are black, and the bottom two rows are red. Also, they have number related, so from left to right, we can name the points or name the number 1, 2, 3 until 13. And on the right side, the three columns, we can see those ones we call the face cards. They coded with different kind of face. They are Jack, Queen, and King. So let's take this example. We do an experiment. This experiment is about picking up a card from a standard set of cards and check the result. So how many possible outcomes this experiment would include? Obviously, the answer is 52. Since there are 52 different kind of cards in the standard set of cards. Let's look at some Example events. You can make up all kinds of events. If we say the card is a heart, it sounds like we are doing the guessing or gambling game. Before we have this card chosen and turn it over, find the result, we do not know which card going to show up. So we can guess the card is a heart. So when we guess the card is a heart, this is called an event. So think about this event, how many possible outcomes may be in this event. So we think about the structure of the standard set of card earlier we mentioned. So we have 13 hearts in that standard set. So this event would include 13 possible outcomes. If we talk about another event, the card is a face card. And we think about how many face cards in this standard set. We have 12 possible outcomes. So 12 face card, anyone could be chosen, could be picked up. So this event includes 12 possible outcomes. Another event, we say the card is a red. Since we mentioned the structure about the standard set of card, we know the two bottom rows are red, so we have 26 possible outcomes included in this event. Next event, the card has number 8. So this event would have 4 possible outcomes. Since each symbol, each character, we have number 8. We have club 8, spade 8, heart 8, and diamond 8. Next event, the card is diamond 5. And we know that is a unique diamond 5. There only one this kind of card in the standard set. So this one only includes one possible outcome. With this kind of experience of the classical experiment, so we assume every single possible outcome has the same chance to appear. So in that case, the classical probability can be defined as the proportion or percentage by simply counting. We count how many possible outcomes in that event and how many possible outcomes for the experiment. So this proportion would give us the idea how much chance that event may happen after that experiment is done. For example, what is the probability of getting a diamond card? The same experiment we were talking about, picking up a card from a standard set. So the total possible outcomes for this experiment, we have 52. And this event, diamond card, how many diamond cards? We have 13 diamond cards. So the probability is 25%, a quarter. Second, what is the probability of getting a card ace? And we know there are 4 aces in the standard set. So the probability would be 4 out of 52, and it is 1 out of 13. We can write down this fraction as the answer, or we can do the calculation, 1 divided by 13, come out the decimal number or percentage. Next example, what is the probability to get a card which is more than 10 points? So more than 10 points, they are the face cards. So we know we have 12 face cards in total. So 12 out of 52 would be the probability. And that is 3 out of 13. What is the probability to get a club ace? There's only one club ace in the standard set. So we have the probability 1 over 52. Some relationship of the events. One we call the mutually exclusive. if two events cannot happen together, and they are called mutually exclusive. If event A and event B, they cannot appear at the same time, we say they are mutually exclusive. If A and B are mutually exclusive, then the probability of A and B would be zero. A and B is said joint probability. That means both happen. For example, a card picking up from a set of cards. Standard set. You only pick up one card, so this one card cannot be heart and spade at the same time. Can only be heart, possibly be spade, but cannot be both. So in that case, showing up a heart and showing up a spade, they are two events mutually exclusive. They cannot happen together. Another typical relationship is called collectively exhaustive. If one of two events must occur when an experiment is conducted, then the two events are called collectively exhaustive. For example, raining or not raining must occur in any day. They against each other. Raining, not raining are collectively exhaustive. One of them must occur. One of them must happen. From here, we can come this idea complementary event. If events A and B, the two events, they are mutually exclusive and collectively exhaustive, then B is called a complement of A. That means A and B, they are exactly opposite each other. So the B can be denoted as A bar or A C. C on the top right corner come from complementary. So A bar or A C means A not happen. Opposite part. Obviously we have A bar and A, they are collectively exhaustive and they are mutually exclusive and the probability together must be 100%. So PA bar and PA equals 1. And you have many different ways to write it out. You can say PA bar equals 1 minus PA, or you can say PA equals 1 minus PA bar. Here, we learn some probability rules. Event A and event A bar can be showing in the diagram, and you can see this relationship clearly. That's earlier we just mentioned, complementary relationship. If event A and event B are mutually exclusive, clearly we can see they do not have joined part in the diagram. So they cannot happen together. That also means P, A and B equals zero. Probability A and B is zero. And here give us the special rule of addition. If we try to look at probability A or B, A or B means inclusive. Could be A happening or B happening, could be both happen. Since both happening, there's no chance. They do not have joined part. So A or B can be translated or transformed to probability A and probability B together. Add them together directly. This can only be done if they are mutually exclusive. So this is called a special rule of addition. General rule of addition. Generally speaking, if A and B not mutually exclusive, then they may happen together. They happen together, which is a joined part. They have a little bit of overlap from the diagram showing. You can see that. So the joined part is A and B. So when we have PA, probability A, and the probability B add together, and we realize, we calculate the proportion of area A and the proportion of area B, and join the part, we basically add it twice. So if we want this whole yellow area inclusive the probability, that means we need to take out one time the joint part. So that turned out the general rule of addition exactly what it means. So probability of A or B equals to probability A plus probability B minus probability A and B. The whole yellow area means event A or B, which is inclusive of A and B. A or B is also called the union event, and A and B is called the joint event, which is the overlapped area. General rule of addition can be applied anytime. For any two events, there's no condition for this. It is always true. Here have the example. A survey received from 200 visitors who visited Toronto area during the year revealed that 120 tourists visited the CN Tower and 100 tourists went to Toronto Islands and 60 tourists visited both attractions. What is the probability that a person randomly selected from this survey visited either CN Tower or Toronto Islands? So we can apply this general rule of addition directly. We're looking for probability visited the CN Tower or Islands. So it can be translated to probability CN Tower, probability of the people visited Islands, and take out the probability people visit both. So we have the clear information, the data. How many people actually visited the CN Tower? Is 120 out of 200. So this gives us the probability. How many people visited the islands? 100. So 100 out of 200. And how many people visited both? We have 60. 60 out of 200. So this kind of probability, based on the historical data, based on the survey data, the results being observed, they also called empirical probability. So finish this calculation, give us 160 out of 200, which is 0.8 or 80%. So 80% of chance randomly pick up this person from this survey. The person visited CN Tower or Islands. See you next time.